Hello students, today we will solve the second problem of 14 marks in case of cash flow statement. So this problem has come for 2008. From the following income statement and balance sheet of Mahesh Limited, prepare a cash flow statement as per accounting standard 3 under indirect method for the year ending 31/3/17. So students, we have net sales 4,03,200. In this, cost of sales is deducted 3,16,800. Depreciation is deducted 9,600. So you should add, because depreciation is a non-cash expense, you should add in operating activity. Salary ignore, operating expenses ignore. Provision for tax, it's 14,080. It's a non-cash expense, you should add. It's a tax meant to pay in future. So two items is minused, so those items you need to add back. Depreciation 9,600 and provision for tax 14,080. So you get net. So now we need to look into the balance sheet, students. Share capital. Compared to last year, current year, there is an increase in share capital of 13,440. So it will come in finance activity. PL account completely ignore because we have taken interim profit of 11,520. So we are not considering last year profit, current year profit as such. As easy purpose, we are taking an interim profit of 11,520. So ignore the profit and loss account. Creditor. There is a decrease in creditor to the extent of 960. Compared to last year, current year, there is a decrease in creditor to the extent of 960. It means creditors are paid minus. Outstanding expenses, there is an increase compared to last year. So total increase is 3,840. So increase. So students, you need to prepare provision for tax account because there is an adjustment even in the PL account as such. So it's a liability by balance brought down 1920. Okay, it's a liability. You need to begin in the credit side. By balance brought down 1920. By profit and loss account 14,080. It's called the provisions made during the year. So it's given in the income statement. Then IT paid, whenever you pay tax is an expense, so tax paid will come in debit side, debit all expenses and losses. If you provide provisions, it will come in credit side. So if tax is provided, credit side. If tax is paid, debit side. So income tax paid, you get a differencing answer 13,888. So opening balance, then closing balance 2,112. Then credit side you write by PL account because out of profit only you have created a provision in the income statement. So total the credit side 16,000 minus 2,112. You get IT paid 13,888. So this will come in finance activity. Then accumulated depreciation account should be prepared because they are given the balance of accumulated depreciation account in the liability side. So by balance brought down 19,200. Next, by depreciation 9600 given in income statement. Then you take closing balance 21,120. So you get 7,680 as a remaining depreciation on building and equipment. So depreciation on building and equipment is 7,680. So building and equipment account, students, is an asset to balance brought down 57,600 by depreciation, that which we found in accumulated depreciation account, 7,680. Then there is a profit on sale of building given in the income statement. So in income statement they are given 1920 building and equipment, so it will come in the debit side, because in profit and loss account it will come in credit side. So differencing figure is 40,320. It was treated as a purchase of building and equipment. Next, you need to calculate the cash flow from operating activity. Current year net profit 11,520. As I told, we have taken interim profit. Add depreciation 9,600 deducted in the question. Add provision for tax 14,080 deducted in the question. Add increase in outstanding expenses liability. Add decrease in stock current asset. So you get 65,920 less decrease in creditor current liability. Less increase in debtor current asset, less increase in advance current asset. So you get operating activity 61,888. It's a plus figure, indicates that it's a inflow, not an outflow. Next, cash flow from investing activity. You get only purchase and sale. So purchase of land 7,680. Then we have purchase of equipment 40,320. So you get minus figure because there is no sale. Sale is treated as an income. Purchase is treated as expense. So we have only purchase. We don't have any sale. So you get minus 48,000, which indicates it's a cash outflow, not an inflow. Next, calculation of cash flow from finance activity. So we have issue of share 13,440, less dividends paid 11,520. Less IT paid 13,888, so you get minus 11,968, indicates that it says a outflow, not an inflow. So students, final overall statement, cash flow statement as on 31st March 16. Cash flow from operating activity 61,888. Next, cash flow from investing activity minus 48,000. Cash flow from finance activity minus 11,968. So two minus figure and plus one figure. So 61,888 minus 48,000 minus 11,968. You get 1,920. So students, add the opening balance 9,600. You should get the resulting figure given in the question. Closing cash 11,520. Okay, thank you, students.